What's going on? It's Big Guns and Pistols. I just wanted to come back for a minute, give you guys a quick word on some thoughts that I've been having. I haven't posted a video in a while. I told you all that I'm working on my other YouTube channel, but something is pretty heavy on my mind, and I'm just jump straight into it. It is my opinion that real men who know how to lead, who understand leadership, who understand structure and order, who understand how to protect and how to be a protector. Being a protector doesn't necessarily mean that when something happens, you're able to right there on the spot defend and protect. It also means that you're able to think through situations to keep yourself or your loved ones from even going through a difficult situation. American men, you need to be armed, man. Not just armed with pistols and rifles and things like that. You need to be armed with knowledge as well. You need to be armed with understanding as well. You have to be armed. But it's not just about being armed with those things I mentioned. You need to have body armor for protection, the proper body armor. All of the things that you see a SWAT team with, many of the things that you see the military with, boots, pants, the proper gear to go to war, you should have. You should be trying to team up with other men, creating something like a militia. You are a militia, you just don't even know it. But that's a topic for another video. But you never know when something is going to happen, whether it be with society or whether it be with many of these ruthless police officers. It doesn't matter who it is. You need to be armed with the things that are necessary to protect yourself, your squadron of men, your family, whatever. And again, I'm talking about body armor, helmets, goggles if necessary, night vision goggles, the proper ammunition needed, enough ammunition. See, too often, damn near all the time, we leave the house and, you know, it's just like any other day. But you have to be just as prepared as they are. Or you have to have access to the type of gear you need to do whatever you need to do. I showed you guys my 308 AR-10. Which is something I'll use for long distance if I ever need to. You know, I'm going to be picking up some match ammunition soon. But I want to apologize to you guys for not posting as much. I haven't abandoned the channel. It's just that I've been putting a lot of time and effort into my other channel, getting that together. But I do want to make more videos, and what I think I'm going to do is I'm just going to start pulling out my phone like I'm doing now and just start recording and then just post it. But men, you have to stay a thinker. And the reason I say men, because let's be real, that men run society. A woman sure as fuck can't do it. I'm not going to get into any of this nonsense. A woman is just as equal as a man is. She is not. She has her place. Men have their place. You men, stay armed, stay thinking. The government and the system that we live under, they try to control you and I as much as they possibly can. They try to keep a grip on the people as much as they possibly can. They limit the laws. You know, they try to erase the Second Amendment as much as they can. They try to neuter it as much as they can. It's about controlling the people. None of this shit has to do with protecting Americans or keeping Americans safe. When you look at the IRS, they have armed up like a fucking military. The IRS has armed themselves like a fucking military. What the fuck do the IRS need with military weaponry? Ammunition. All sorts of other things. Shields. You need to get yourself a shield. You need to start putting money or a piece of your money into defense. See, the American people, we're entirely too divided. And I sit and watch this shit and I understand it. I understand it. I understand exactly what they're doing. They sit in, they'll do certain things to keep people at odds with one another, to keep people fighting with one another, to keep Americans at one another's throats. I see them do this shit all the time, whether it be over gun control, whether it be over, you know, this LGBT stuff, and other things, certain laws. I sit and watch how they will create and orchestrate arguments and difference between Americans. They know how to keep people fighting with one another. They know how to keep people at odds with one another. You got, you know, half the country is for the Second Amendment. You know, you got a large portion that's not, and they use that against us to keep us into it with one another. Police are out here. You're not even fucking policing. You're giving people tickets for tinted windows. You giving people... Listen, many of you know I live in the Chicagoland. With all the crime, robberies, muggings, murders, anything you can name within crime, etc., police are out here giving people tickets for tinted fucking windows. This is the system that we live under. And the police officer, their attitude is just to... And I know they don't give a fuck, and I understand, but guess what? You know... never mind. I'm not even going to say what I was thinking to say here on YouTube. That's why I need to get a Patreon. But you people, you have got to be in the position to be a very, very dangerous man, regardless of what you look like. Because you got to understand first that what people do is they look at you. They size you up. And they think they know your capabilities simply by sizing you up, you know, by eyeballing you. Boy, are they in for a rude awakening. They are in for a rude, disturbing awakening. Little do they know, you'll be fucking damaged in a blink of an eye. So when you know that people, they just simply might look at you and size you up and may not think much of you, regardless of that, you need to be a very, very, very dangerous man. You need to have skills. You need to have skills to kill people.